What's up YouTube fam, what's up PP squad, and welcome to another video guys. So in this video we have something very different for you. Like we said, on the PP channel we'll keep on bringing you guys bangers that you need. Honestly, I've been in China for a while now and I've come to just meet people that are able to inspire me. I've come to meet people that are able to help me go to the place where I want you to be with how my Chinese is and how everything is about me as a person. And with me today is one of those people, and honestly after this you will just see how determined and hardworking this person is. Honestly, he's laughing now because he's very modest, let me just say that. Like honestly, everyone is squeezed like, oh, Lin Lao Shi, and he's just a student for that matter. So guys, this is someone that you should pay attention to, so let's get into the video.
I got pictures.
So before, this is how the boy looks. Francis can word it for the like short interview sort of thing.
Make a learning become
a yeah. Voila! It's now a man, no? Chombos. Don't you want to say?
What's
yeah, people look nice.
How?
Yeah. Yeah. Ladies sitting on your left and right. My brother, where have you been all this while? Camera woman now. Yeah. Imagine she also wants to get a haircut at this point. He should just introduce himself, tell us something about himself so that we can get to know him better. So maybe you could introduce yourself and where you're from.
Okay, thank you for inviting me. My name is Cedric. I'm doing civil engineering in China. I'm in my last year and I'm from Congo. Okay, the guy invited me, I'm just honored to get this invitation. And I don't know what to say. Okay, maybe share some experience about life in China.
Yeah.
Because it has been now 3 years and a half since I've been in China. It has been tough, but okay, we overcome all the situation and all the hard time and all the good time. It's okay so far.
Yeah, and compared to everyone of us, everyone in the school says this, me included. Is Chinese, is it's there. So guys, if you think you can come to China and your Chinese is going to be bad, although you put in the hard work, this is proof that the minute you put your mind to something, good things are going to start happening. So let's just listen, because honestly I'm always inspired. Like I always look up to him. Like if I need advice, I'm also doing civil engineering, I'll just come to him and he's always there. Like honestly, you would think he doesn't even study, but I'm telling you, it's the best in his stream, which does not make sense. So honestly, there's just so much to say, and like him being here and showing us so many different things, like you can make it. This is the best language in the world. He's made it. He's still managing his academics and he's still there, able to help us as other students who are in the first, second and third year, which is a good thing. So now, honestly, he also has a business, which is, can it get better than this, guys? Can it seriously get better than this? So this is one person that's really like putting the effort in making sure things just pan out nicely in life. And we honestly want to find out where your business is concerned. Like, how?
Okay, so far, I came in China in 2017. And at that time, it was hard. I didn't know anyone. No one was there to helping me. The first thing I've noticed, like, okay, it was hard to get along alone when you don't know Chinese. Because everywhere, the roads, the magazine, okay, the shops, or all the transport, they are written in Chinese. So you have to be good in Chinese in order to get your way out. So the first thing I asked to myself when I reached in China, it was like, what could happen to me if I get lost one day? That was the first question I asked myself when I came in China. And I say, okay, if I don't know this language, it's gonna be hard for me to find my way out once I get lost. I started with my major in 2017, that is civil engineering, and all my classmates, they did Chinese language before, so we were in class, and then it was the Lao Shi is like teacher in Chinese. The teacher was asking questions, and then my friend just were fast to reply, to answer the question, the answers. Okay, I was, oh my god, what am I doing in this in this class? Am I in the right classroom, or I'm just lost? And then I talked to myself, okay, if those people, they can speak Chinese right now, they didn't do some magic, they didn't do something impossible, so I can do the same. And for that time, I gave myself a determination and a dream. That word was like, either I'm gonna be better than them or like them. That was my first sentence I did. And so far, I met a guy from my country. The first time he was like, okay, bro, I wanna go and give someone a haircut. Yeah. And so, oh, okay, that's nice. Can I go with you? He said, okay, we went to one of the dormitory. He was actually supposed to give to two people the haircut. He gave to the first guy the haircut, but it took long. I was wondering what the guy was doing there. And then I was, man. And when the guy came out after the haircut, okay, I was judging inside. So, man, this guy is not good. And I was not that good because I couldn't use the clip at that time. I was just good with the comb and the blade. And I asked, can I cut the next guy? He said, okay, if the guy accepts, I asked, bro, can I do a haircut? He said, okay, no problem. The guy was also from Congo. I just get my comb and then my blade. I start giving. After 35 minutes, I finished to cut hair. And then the guy came and said, whoa, bro, where did you learn this? I said, okay, I learned that when I was in the boarding school. That is in 2011, when I was in the boarding school. And then he said, yo, man, you know, with this talent, you can make money in China, because all the foreigner here, the Chinese, they cannot cut their hair. The hairstyle they want is a bit hard for Chinese to go along with it. So, okay, I said, how can I start? So, since you know people, it's better for you to introduce me. Whenever you go, if I cut someone, okay, I can give you a part, maybe 10% or something like that. He said, no, you don't need to give me something. It's your work. So, if they pay you, it's okay. And that time, I remember I bought a clipper. It was 35 on top of. 35 is like... At that time, it was like $5. I bought the clipper. It was a plastic one, just to get along and then to run. So when I came in China, is the time I learned how to use the clipper. But back home, I was using the comb, and I was trying to get, okay, to know with customers, to let them know, like, okay, I can do the haircut. And I started, so far, so good. The word guy was also, it was very good. And everyone was going to his place to get a haircut. And after that, I just trust myself, like, okay, it's hard. All the beginning are always hard. And I just keep on the same time with my classes, with my business, and then with my Chinese language. I was going out every day learning. I used a lot of method to learn Chinese. And sometimes people, when they meet me, they say, bro, how your Chinese so good like this? I say, okay, man. It's just, okay, first I say it's the grace of God, because, okay, the grace of God is the one who gives everything we need. I ask him to give me that ability to learn this language as fast as I can, and he gave me that opportunity. So I was just putting my effort in it. Every day, waking up so early at 6:30, going upstairs to practice first the tone. It's very important for people, if you want to learn the Chinese language, you start with the tone, so that you're gonna get used to the pinyin and then the pronunciation. And later on, I was practicing now with the writing, how to write the characters. And the way I was writing the characters, it was like every day I have to write something somewhere. And those paper was like, I write something, I just scratch them and throw in the dustbin. The next day I just write again and do the same thing. And whenever people at the rest, like at the break time, around like 12:15, the international students, they used to come back to the dormitory for lunch. But most of the time I was staying in the classroom and the blackboard to practice by myself. And I was asking if I found some Chinese guy to just give me the dictation and to try if I can still remember the characters and write them correctly. That was so.
COVID, people have been unable to come to China, and most of them are saying studying difficulty in studying Chinese, what advice would you give people that are unable to come to China right now?
Okay, we know that this situation of the pandemic is a global situation, and it's hard to give to define whether it's gonna finish early or later, but it cannot block us to learn or to read something about what you really like. The first thing is you have to get passion. Everything about learning, everything you're gonna do in life, you have to get first passion and then motivation. Because if you have a passion and the motivation, it will determine the way you're gonna read or you're gonna learn something. Chinese I don't mind. The Chinese I do or the Chinese I can speak right now, I didn't learn it in school. It was all my own effort, because the documents are there, the PDF are there, the records are also there. You just need to listen and repeat, because Chinese is a tonic language. It means it's based on the sound. So you have to listen to a sound and copy that sound so that you may be able to reproduce it. If you reproduce it, that means you know how to speak Chinese. If you are not able to reproduce the sound, so you have to check and adjust yourself. You have the CD, right now the Beijing language university, they've noticed, they've taken care of about the problem. They've noticed people, they cannot get access to the touchable document like the books. So what they did, they create the PDF and the link where people, they can easily go and download the document and they record. The document, the record is actually based on the PDF. You read, you listen, and you repeat. You read, you listen, and you repeat. The more you read, the more you listen, the more you repeat, that's gonna help you to become fluent in this language.
Very good advice, which we should really take up. And also, touching on the business side, this is just showing how innovative our students we can be in China. Because really, there's other students in China that are doing businesses, and his business stands out to me because everyone in school is coming to him. And honestly, this I would say is good money. Just thinking about it, this is really good money, because everyone in school is coming to him. Everyone trusts. No, I want to get a haircut. Everyone will say, go to Cedric. He has a group of over 200 people. And 200 people and each haircut is how much? So just start calculating. Start thinking of how much a person that's there, making sure their grades are up, their Chinese is good. And the guys, honestly, like I'm saying, I'm a bit biased with this one. Because I look up to him. So let me just say that. So, is there any advice here for those of us who are in China and what we can do?
Okay, first of all is the business I've noticed, this haircut is my father, is my mother. Why am I saying that? Because I base everything on this. At the first time, I was not really caring about this business, because at that time, I was receiving money from back home. I know at the end of the month, they will send me some money, so I don't care, I don't have any stress. But there was a time stuff getting hard now back home, and I came to realize that if I don't find a way to solve a problem, it's gonna be over for me in China. So this is how I work in China. I define my life in China. My tuition fees, they are paid based on my intelligence and my ability. My dormitories and accommodation fees, they are paid according to my business. So I make sure I cut hair, and I make sure when I give a haircut, the guy, I don't take picture of people. The haircut I do is gonna do the marketing for me. That is it. So I just try to save whatever I do. I know if I save money with the haircuts, I can get per month, I can reach 4,000 renminbi. That is around $500, right? $500. And this one, if I save it well, I can pay my accommodation. I can pay also my living allowance, right? And apart from being that, I make sure I adjust my schedule so that I didn't disturb my studies, my leisure time, and my work. So I just thanks God for this ability I get. And I can mangle everything at the same time.
And it's very playful, let me just say that. You know the school groups? It's he never sleeps. He's the one who's always commenting. You think he has nothing else to do. But
yeah.
Yeah. So guys, honestly, we're very grateful to have you today, and we're grateful that you are able to sit down with us today.
Yeah,
and if you have any more questions that you would like to ask him, please do leave a comment and I'll be sure to ask him and I'll get back to you. So thank you very much, guys.
Thank you, guys. Okay.